My name is Diane Allan.
I am the Vice President of Science Branch at the Canadian Food Inspection Agency.
I first became interested in science when I was a teenager, and I was exposed to a program called Let's Talk Science at the time, and that's what really inspired me to see how I could actually contribute to advancing science for the greater good of Canadians. And I would say that, you know, working through regulatory organizations and being in a science-based department, I shine in that world, right? I really enjoy understanding the science, doing the science, and translating the science. And that's what brought me to the role that I'm in now as the Vice President of Science. So although I don't work in a lab every day, I understand what they do in the lab. When I started in the public service, there were much more men than there were women in the public service. And I think the obstacle that I faced the most is, as an energetic and very passionate person, I came across either competitive or traumatic. And I think that did put a bit of a stigma on me. Things have changed dramatically since then. I think we have a much more balanced approach in terms of women versus men in leadership and management positions. But at the time when I started 20 plus years ago, it was not that great. I think that the current and future way of supporting women in science are really ensuring that women have the right support, whether it be mentors, coaches, advocates, people who are allies to them to help them through their career path. And that's something they do really, really well at the Canadian Food Inspection Agency. We do have good tools and support mechanisms exist for women. And it's critical that we do that on a regular occurrence because, you know, women are exposed to different milestones versus what men may be exposed to, right? They do take that nurturing side. And that kind of does put them a bit of an awkward situation sometimes in their career path. So by having the right allyship and mentors and coaches, we're able to help navigate women through the system. The advice that I would have for women currently and future in science is just continue to be determined, persistent, and keep navigating to get your dreams accomplished, right? Lucky me, I am the Vice President of Science Branch, so it's not impossible, it is possible to get there. So just keep being persistent and keep having that dream and follow through on your commitment.